Why are you doubling down, and what is the money being used for?
Well, first of all, thanks so much for having us here. It's a really exciting time for the company. We're coming out of this year with a series of research breakthroughs where we've now shown that we can use AI to design molecules that we never even thought was going to be possible. So we're really using this money to double down on that research agenda. The models show no signs of slowing down. And then also really growing the team and starting to take these models and start deploying them really at scale and starting to create new molecules that, again, we never thought would have been possible to create.
Elena, it feels like this is a relatively pivotal moment in AI's push forward on drug discovery and on healthcare more broadly. You're someone who invests in life sciences. What is it that made Chai stand out that you thought it needed follow-on money just 3 months after a Series A?
Absolutely. So Chai stood out because 2025 was the year of AI discovery. And what Chai allows you to do is understand and predict the interaction between molecules to design and develop new medicines. And the reason we invested now is because we believe 2026 will be the year of deployment, and pharmaceutical companies that adopt this technology will absolutely leapfrog those who do not. And it's a moment where medicines that could not be discovered any other way will now be discoverable.
And the aha moment in many ways was following the release of Chai 2, Josh. Just tell us why that was so important, the latest antibody generation model that you released and I'm sure suddenly had a load of inbound calls on the back of.
Yeah, so of course this is our Series B, but if you look back at our Series A, we told our investors that over the next 2 years or so, we would try to reach a 1% success rate on this antibody design task, meaning that 1% of the molecules coming out of our models would function in the lab. We thought that'd be a breakthrough moment of the field. But a couple months ago with Chai 2, we actually announced that we could do this with about a 15 to 20% success rate. So I think really leapfrogging again what even we thought was achievable in the past year or so. So that's really been, I think, a big moment for the field. And now moving us away from just research curiosities into models that are really useful for actually discovering drugs.
Elena, that's sort of mind-blowing for many who aren't in the weeds on life sciences as much as you are, that there is only a 1% hit rate was going to be really tangible for the field, and let alone 15 to 20%. Talk to us about what have been the limitations thus far in drug discovery in labs for pharmaceuticals and what this changes in terms of AI.
Absolutely. So when researchers try to make a new model, a new molecule, it's essentially searching for a needle in the haystack. It happens in a lab. There's a lot of variability, and it's really challenging. That's why even though we've seen breakthrough medicines and many people benefit from them, there are still lots of areas where people get sick and have no options. What Chai has done is show that they can design computationally medicines that have over an 85% success rate in achieving basic drug-like properties. There's additional research to do, work to be done that takes a drug from the computer into the lab, into people, into clinical trials. But there's been a long-standing hype around AI for drug discovery. And now when we meet pharmaceutical executives and they meet Chai, everyone says, this is the year of deployment. Now these models work in a way that they will actually contribute to new medicines that make it to patients.
And of course, Josh, you've previously been backed by Thrive Capital, Menlo Ventures, OpenAI has been a strategic investor and a place you used to work. But with General Catalyst and with Oak on site, I'm sure those meetings with pharmaceuticals come more thick and fast. But what more is the money being put towards when you talk about scaling this project? How much compute do you need and how much you need to invest in GPUs as well as the engineers in the fierce talent wars to get the right people in the door to build the models too?
Yeah, well, I'm thrilled to be working with General Catalyst and Oak here. You know, this round is actually about a lot more than the money. You know, you bring together some of the top investors in the space in healthcare. If you look at the folks joining our board, Annie Lamont and Hemant Naja, these are investors who have been modestless healthcare investors, really plugged into the pharma space. We're here with Elena as well, who's just such an incredible thought partner on really building out the business. So the capital is going to work among all the things that you mentioned. We're really putting an astronomical amount of these costs into compute. We're trying to turn compute into better molecules. We run a ton of lab experiments to really test whether the models work in the real world. And we're doing a lot as well in order to start deploying these models, building the right kind of software tooling in order to build this computer-aided design suite for molecules. There's the talent wars as well. I'm very, very grateful to be working with some of the top folks in the industry here. When we started the company, we actually brought together a number of heads of AI from top AI drug discovery companies, and we've only continued to build out an exceptional team here. We're a small but mighty team, but we're really putting this to work in order to turn science from a biology from a scientific discipline into one that looks a little bit more akin to engineering.
Yeah, Elena, for the you said a great line that basically there's been a lot of hype around AI and how it will be applied to healthcare. But what do you think helps cut through to those who are laymen to a lot of the real details and data being shown in this, that we will see productivity gains, we will see real deployment in 2026? What's your hope as to what this looks like next year?
Well, I think for next year, the hope, and I think pretty strongly the reality, is that pharmaceutical companies will be able to discover medicines more efficiently. So Josh mentioned there's a lot of compute going in. That's really on the research side. What's incredible is this technology is efficient. It is helping people discover medicines. And to me, the most important thing that lay people will see is when we use these tools, we can discover medicines that take advantage of known biology and impossible chemistry. You could not make the molecule, you could not make the medicine without using this technology. And what people will see are medicines that are curative that would not have been discovered any other way. And that's where lay people will really see the benefit, is in medicines that have impact on their lives.